welcome to the living room. Tonight, we're featuring a video tribute to the band The Embarrassment, including rare videos, some of which have never been released to the public before. The Embarrassment originally formed in Wichita, Kansas in 1979. They made several recordings before breaking up in 1983. Although some people consider the band punk rock, the band liked to describe their musical style as blister pop. In the early 80s, The Embarrassment set a template for American indie rock, edgy, rocking tunes, full of clever wordplay and subtle wit, played by four guys in thick glasses. The band included guitarist Bill Goffrier, lead singer and organist John Nichols, bassist Ron Klaus, and drummer Brent Woody Geissmann. Our first set includes clips from the early 80s, including locally produced music videos and interview segments featuring the band.
The music sounds fun when it comes from a music box. Over in the corner, you choose the music and a watch. Elastic in beats, enclose the dancing.
Don't you surround the sun. 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 original. We wrote them. They're our songs. And they sound somewhat different from the norm.
But that's not a descriptive term. It doesn't describe the music at all. So we have a hard time when somebody wants us to describe the music. Mm-hmm. We avoid it by telling them, well, we wrote it and it doesn't sound like much anything else. Because if we tell them what bands we think we sound like, they're bands that most people haven't heard of.
What he does is really good, nuanced seance, his fiance. Easy for you to say, Doc, what he thinks he is. Artistic party, narcissistic party, artistic party. She has a book on the subject of fear in her hand. I believe I've walked the party. Artistic party, narcissistic party, artistic party, narcissistic party, artistic party, party, party. Excuse me, is this age a reason? Well, he's the maddest frame of mind. Don't look at his work, watch his head swirl. It's an artistic party goer. Narcissistic party goer. Artistic party goer. Narcissistic party goer.
Brown.
Well, there's bands that want to do. There's bands that are very successful economically, and they get popular appeal by learning how to sound like what people want to hear, what they expect to hear when they go to hear a band. And they get good at that, and they go a long way. Some of them, and that hasn't ever sat well with us. First of all, we wouldn't have had the ability to do it.
Uh-huh.
We couldn't have started that. We couldn't have formed a group to sound like anybody because we didn't have the technique.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We pretty much all learned how to play together.
We never wanted to sound like anybody else or copy styles or anything. It was mostly wanting to do something original.
In set two, Chicago video producer Scott Jacobs was searching the country for new music to promote on the TV show Rock America back in 1981. He videotaped the band performing live in the Flatiron Building in Wichita, playing for an audience of friends.
What it does is really good nuance sounds. It's so easy to say. Thank you.
social service supply. I'm a winning team. We never caught a dinosaur. Nichols got the leg. They offered us a skeleton. So far along, and in the Congo, somewhere, and not the Middle East is from. Red light, prehistoric world, theater of the Congo. busy.
Thank you.
For set three, our final segment, here's another locally produced music video for the band's classic song, Elizabeth Montgomery's Face, produced by Sonia Gredeman.
Put us all on.
Thanks for watching The Living Room. We'd like to thank The Embarrassment for allowing us to show these rare videos to you tonight, and Brian Fitzgerald and Sonia Gredeman. Tune in next week for another music adventure in The Living Room.
Right.